episode of Last Order of Survival 3, we're returning, boys and girls and ladies and gentlemen, we are back at none other than a Junkyard event, which is something that I feel like I have not seen in a freaking hot minute, so it's good to be back. We got Lexi, the most adorable pup over here, ready to help us out with today's adventures, and of course, Paul the Party Pinata continues to nap, and Travis the Flippin' Turtle is here to help us along with today's adventures.
I hope you die.
Now, those are the words of support that we bring Travis along for, and that is why I'm excited to get to clearing this joint out. And speaking of which, we have gotten the version of the Junkyard event that appears to be entirely infested with lots of zombies. There are a multitude of versions. There's one version that actually has pretty much a bunch of raiders. I kind of like that version the most because it tends to have the best loot. However, we appear to have stumbled across the version where, well, that person over back that way, over by that chest over there, yeah, he actually wants to loot up the Junkyard. The problem is he's pretty good at, not necessarily looting. He's actually pretty good at dying to the Junkyard. So we gotta make sure to do a little bit of a cheeky thing here, which is actually try and clear out a little bit of the Junkyard first, because if you gotta sneak by him and make your way into things, you can actually take out some of these initial zombies, and then later on, I mean, you're still gonna be swarmed by zombies. That's still something that we gotta freaking worry about, but it will not be as big of a swarm, which is definitely a plus. 10 out of 10, would love to not get swarmed again. However, there we got one of the bad people, one of the bad zombies, trying to take us down in the form of the Savage Giant. But speaking of things that are not bad, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, as we do know, Season 9 continues to lurk right around the corner, and from a lot of what we know, it is going to be largely a multiplayer-centric update, obviously, with, like, plenty of single-player prizes and stuff like that, but largely a multiplayer-centric update, which is obviously pretty cool just for the fact of all the new multiplayer things that we are going to be getting, including potential things like new locations and obviously plenty of new mechanics that we can't expect. And as we prepare for this brand new Last Day on Earth season to come our way, as we usually know, there's gonna be a brand new season pass along with it, a premium pass. That's why I want to let you guys know a pretty easy way to actually make some extra money ahead of time, so y'all are prepared to cop that premium pass and some of the incredible rewards that will be accompanying it. Opinion Outpost is super easy, and you pretty much end up getting paid for sharing your opinion, so you can pretty much be making money while you are watching Netflix up at night and can't sleep, or even waiting for your friends, literally anywhere and everywhere. And since we are all staying home, this is actually a great way to make some extra money and capitalize on those circumstances. I've personally already been trying it out a little bit and am planning on using some of this extra cash actually for that exact same Season 9 of Last Day on Earth. I am prepared to cop that premium pass and make some awesome content about it for all of you wonderful lads and lassies out there. So make sure y'all head over to that link at the very tippity top of the description to go ahead and start making some money with the help of Opinion Outpost. And a huge thank you to Opinion Outpost for sponsoring the video and supporting the channel. So make sure y'all do take advantage of that and start getting prepared for this upcoming update so we can all be ready to get all of the prizes imaginable that Season 9 does have in store for us. And oh, Nelly, this is no bueno. There's a Savage Giant still continuing to chase us down, but this man is actually about to be swarmed by quite a lot of zombies. Luckily, I will be your body shield, because as long as, like, we need to keep this man alive. And luckily, due to the zombie clearing that we did a little bit ahead of time, thank you for your help, your rewards in the chest. The only reason the chest is open is because we kept this doofus alive, because without our help, he's not very skilled in the art of living. Definitely, he needs a couple of pointers here and there from me. Luckily, me and the rest of the Snipe Squad are ready to help out. We obviously also have Travis and Lexi, who is... Lexi, look at her. She looks at him so adorably. Lexi, do the little belly roll. Look at Lexi's belly. That's right. Lexi helped keep you alive, too. And let's go, baby. That's what I'm talking about. That is one of the, if not very best things that the Junkyard event can have in store for us. A light bulb. No, just kidding. The car battery, a super important component for crafting up your ATV, holds a charge for a long time, used for charging many devices, and even after the ATV is crafted and ready to go, it's still incredibly useful because, well, it is pretty much how you are able to harvest lead and ultimately create the valuable resource known as lead plates, which, for example, do go into the sculpture here. via the car batteries. So even after the ATV is crafted, you still need those things. Now, what I also need is to continue looting this place up, because I want to prioritize on looting up a few of the little, ooh, piece of candy, pretty good things that do remain for us without summoning the wrath of zombies. And that largely comes in the form of those two things that we just looted. The one that we just looted, that little, like, minivan, and then the back of this army truck, which was a little bit disappointing in terms of the loot today, but I got to take those things in stride. You know, things will not always be perfecto, as much as I would love nothing but perfection all the time. However, you do need to be a little bit careful with this event, unless you do want to get into a bit of a bigger tussle, because there are still some more zombies over here in this northern section that that fella does not adventure over to. And while you might be like, Star, loot up these cars, well, the cars tend to not exactly have, like, the greatest loot in the universe for the most part. Actually, this little army truck over here in the back of that minivan tend to have some of the best loot that this event does have to offer, and they don't set off a car alarm. You might be like, oh, Star, but absolutely nothing has happened. Things are happening. Things are happening as we speak. We are being swarmed by the zombies. Luckily, we have the manpower to take these things down, but in exchange for Lexi, shouts out to you. Lexi is a real trooper helping us take down these swarms of zombies. It's so nice to be bringing Lexi back along for an adventure, man. But y'all can see, like, the kind of caliber of loot that we are getting from this. Like, it's okay, but is it worth blowing through some more of our weapon durability, medical supplies, and potentially armor durability? Debatably so, because it's definitely a bit meh on the side of, like, what the loot does potentially have in store for us. But at the very least, we did get what this chest had. And with that, sayonara, Lexi, say goodbye. Not to me, to the man over there. Sayonara. Nice seeing you, and thank you for the invite to the Junkyard event, dude. It's been a hot minute, but speaking of that, like I was saying, there are three versions of the Junkyard event. There is that version over there. There is another version where we also need to help out the fella, but he's a little bit of a different fella. He requires us to bring him an engine, and we can actually find engines within some of those cars in the Junkyard. However, thing with that, right, is every time you pick up an engine, you actually get swarmed by zombies. And sometimes, if you have an engine, if you're in a bad position, you won't be able to drop it. And I've had very bad things happen from the Junkyard due to that exact same fact that I am spitting right there. So that version's a little bit poopier. But personally, I love the Raider version, because we can tussle and hustle with some Raiders. If we're lucky, find some shotguns and even multiple car batteries through a single event. And, like, trust me when I'm saying this, y'all. I was not kidding when I say that car batteries are incredibly important, specifically for harvesting actually lead ore, which is exactly what we have chilling over there within our lead crate, which I do have a little bit of a collection of, because it's kind of cool to collect it. And I don't exactly need the lead at the moment, and we can always refine this ore crate into quite literally lead, but I do love to have that car battery stockpile, because when you head to the swamps, that is when you can actually use the car battery in conjunction with this, like, mining / drilling rig to collect those crates, which you can then toss into the acid bath, which at the time being I am using as a glorified chest, because, well, sorry about the burp there. I don't know how to really put this kindly, but I have almost no inventory room free. Quite literally, every chest in my repertoire is filled with so much freaking jazz. It is ridiculous, man. That is what we get for being freaking raidaholics. Speaking of raidaholics, we got a raid lined up for today. That's right. The exact same thing that is filling up our chest to the point where we have a storage issue. And we're gonna continue doing that because it's just way too much fun. But also, the thing that I do love about that Junkyard event is its ability to also gather cogs and rubber, just rubber, not rubber parts, but quite literally rubber, which are both also used in the crafting of the ATV and I believe various other recipes too. And just in general, it is good to have rare resources stockpiled, because with future updates, like, for example, season 9, even though season 9 is gonna be primarily multiplayer, let's say the next single player update, you know, for example, you never know what new content is gonna be added and what resources you require. That is why I have such a large stockpile of literally every resource imaginable, because you never know when you're gonna be needing to tap into some of the stuff. Here's our freaking supercharged first aid kit chest, by the way, where I have been investing a lot of the ash logs that we have, or ash planks, I should say, that we have been acquiring from our swamp runs, because you can get ash logs, which you can then refine into ash planks, which you can then use to upgrade the capacity of Rex. That is right. You might be like, Star, are, oh my god, you are a hacker. You have a stack of 45 first aid kits. Well, that's exactly how you can expand your storage after you do upgrade to racks. There's not like a better one you can upgrade to, but you can upgrade the rack itself. So every time that you upgrade it, it actually adds 5 to the storage capacity. Now, for the sake of science, we're gonna go ahead and apply a few of those upgrades. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's just go ahead and get to grabbing some of those ash planks. We also have plenty of iron plates and steel plates, and let's go ahead and apply that exact same upgrade we were talking about. And now check it out. We go from 45 to a stack, boom, to 50. Oh, what's that? DJ Khaled, another one. Let's go ahead and do it again, and we can continue consolidating a lot of our storage. And due to the fact that we can stack up individual tiles to be bigger, we then end up having significantly more room to spare. So this is a really good thing to do with the things that you have large stacks of, like, for example, some of our factory parts we are stockpiling here. Obviously, the first aid kits, because I have a lot of these, and they are very useful. That is why I love finding them in raids, because they keep me from dying, which is 10 out of 10 would not die again. So yeah, just want to make sure to go ahead and show that off on the Lickety Splits, because I am aware that it's been a little bit of a while since I have actually shown these racks getting manually upgraded, because it's just kind of me trying to sort through my freaking hoarding issues personally. But it's a very useful tool exactly for that, and one of the big draws of once you get your ATV crafted up, you can start expanding your storage like this with the usage of those ash planks, which is so freaking big. Not to mention the location of it, because we also do have this stored within our kind of like little steel room. So it's kind of nice, because within the most protected parts of your base, you can actually kind of expand the storage room of the most protected parts of your base, so we can continue storing the most valuable things we have within the steel part of our base, so it has an absolutely 0% chance of getting broken into. Because at the time of me recording this, and for like literally like what the past like the existence like the past 3 years or the existence of Last Day on Earth, these steel walls have not been able to be broken into, despite the tease of a metal cutter that might very well be able to do such a thing. But now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I know some of y'all are probably like yelling at the screen like, Star, goodness gracious, organize your inventory. Dude, every time I try to have an organized base, I just end up getting more loot, and then it just slowly gets more and more disorganized. Like, it's just, that's why I've been trying to invest so heavily into expanding the storage of some of those like rack chests, but like, it's very expensive. It literally takes, for every single upgrade of +5, takes 40 ash planks, which fun little fact, by the way, let me just go ahead and show it off for all of y'all that may or may not know about the mythical and magical properties of these ash planks. It takes 5 ash logs to create 1 ash plank. So to get 40 planks for an upgrade, that takes 200 logs. Okay, quick maths. You get 2 logs per oak tree you chop down. You quite literally need to chop down 100 oak trees. Not oak, ash. I don't know where the poop oak came from. 100 ash trees to get enough logs to get enough ash planks. So yeah, a little bit on the pricey side. Obviously, there are some pretty cool things that you can use to utilize, and I highly do recommend. For example, there's a very cool recipe that you can craft up within your kitchen stove once you do get this thing crafted on up, and that comes in the form of salmon soup. It increases the amount of wood that you obtain. So with the usage of a salmon, carrot, mushroom, and canned food, you can create this, and it will buff you, and then you can get the salmon, of course, by visiting various fishing locations, especially, I think, like, the winter fishing locations, and, like, some of the northern ones actually have a poop ton of salmon, so it's definitely a good pickup in that regard. And before we do head out on today's raiding adventure, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's not forget to make sure that our pistols are properly equipped for the task at hand. This is a base pistol. It does 66 damage per second. Boom! With all of the fully modifications, yes, we can now turn this into quite the beast at 103 damage per second. Increase the damage, speed, critical chance, noise, critical damage, range, and durability. The weight is worse, but for all of these other increases, more than worth it. Not to mention, of course, the usage and equipping of a silencer, because without that, this thing would make noise. And if we're going on a raid, you don't really want to cause a ruckus, I tell you what. So just go ahead and equip ourselves with another one of those. And seriously, the pistol is just personally, like, if y'all could focus on getting any modifications for a gun. Obviously, I think that melee modifications are definitely a better overall investment just due to how much more plentiful melee modifications are. And for the most part, they do not require some expensive things. Like, for example, here, like high-tech components aren't as widespread. Or factory parts, which are quite the pain in the bum to acquire, but it's definitely nice to be, once you do acquire them, I'd say to put them towards your pistol, since the pistol is pretty much the most common, widespread, and kind of versatile weapon. Don't get me wrong, like, this Winchester and zip gun might technically be easier to get, but those are just a whole different level, dude. The pistol's just significantly better and definitely something you should be pushing for. But besides that, man, I mean, some saw blade maces, some machetes go a long way. And dude, we do have, after all, a godchete, as I call it, which is the usage of the godhook blade and the bone handle for quite the terrifying terror of damage. Yeah, like, if you do manage to get these two together, this is why it's so nice, because, like, you mainly do get, like, the components for crafting bone equipment, for example. Like, this one right over here, the bone pointer, largely does come with the biggest roadblock being the presence of big bones, which are pretty much loot that largely is dropped by various bosses throughout last day on Earth, such as, the little, like, mini-boss at the farm. Obviously, the witch is someone who does have it, and various peeps like that. So, definitely, it's a little bit trickier to get some of those, because you do need to undertake some pretty big battles, and they are not guaranteed to drop the big bones either. But it is a pretty good investment for getting some pretty good things put together. And speaking of putting some good things together, we're gonna put together a little bit of fun raid of player 6529. Let's start heading over there. But yeah, with that, like, machete or whatnot that I was talking about, normally the machete does, like, what, like, 30 damage? With the proper modifications, we turn that thing into a 37 damage machete. And then, if you do talk to the healer at your base and he gives you, like, the extra damage boost to your melee weapons, that machete literally starts doing 45 damage. That is literally as powerful as a sledgehammer, except way bloody faster and quite the murder machine. But enough about the murder machines, because, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we got some fun stuff about season 9 we gotta go over. Boom! And that's exactly what you're seeing right here, right now. So this was shared by the developers of Last Day on Earth with the caption, "The upcoming update wouldn't be complete without new bikes. This time you are gonna see a real neon ghost that you will be able to obtain in the crater and use in the main single player mode. The update itself is currently being tested. Search for a clan to join and welcome to the crater." So again, we do see the Last Day on Earth developers continue emphasizing how important being in a clan will be, which is really cool news, because that means that clans are going to become significantly more important into the crater, which means that there are going to be clan specific features, potentially even something crazy like PvP finally being added, some player versus player action. But if not, even like new clan zones that you can head out to, potentially like building up a base in a clan. A lot of these different possibilities are being pointed to with what the Last Day on Earth developers are kind of like repeatedly hinting towards with this importance of the clan. And they do continue talking about how the update is still being tested. So it's been being tested for a while at this point, for what they've been saying, because earlier this week, I think like on like Monday or Tuesday or something like that, they said the update was a few days away from dropping, which very well could have been pointing towards the end of that week. However, that time appears to have come and passed. But with them saying a few days, like literally almost a week ago, you gotta imagine that early this week is when we can't expect this brand new season 9 multiplayer crater update to go ahead and drop. And with it, this little like post does further confirm that the rewards that we get throughout this multiplayer action will be, they will transfer into single player. So like, you're not just like the season, the battle pass rewards are going to be sent to single player, but I think a lot of the tasks that the battle pass is going to encompass are going to be multiplayer centric, along with like the season at large. So I know that might be quite controversial, because obviously the single player portion is the most popular portion of Last Day on Earth as is, but it is good to see them continue developing multiplayer, because that means the multiplayer will continue getting better to the point where hopefully it is on par, if not better, than the single player experience. Because I think that would be the ultimate thing, is like if we could have the single player experience and like all the features and locations and all that in a multiplayer setting that we can experience with our clans. That's the dream for Last Day on Earth, and they continue making those strides and steps towards that dream. And the awesome thing is that they are two separately different modes, so if you run out of energy in single player, you did all your things for the day while you wait for your energy to recharge, maybe walk to a zone, you can very easily just, you know, switch to multiplayer mode at the tap of a button. Obviously, they said multiplayer is going to be dropping to level 15, so before you had to be level 150 to do multiplayer, now it's going to be level 15. So significantly better on that portion too, is a little bit of a recap of some of the info that we have heard thus far. So overall, it's definitely going to be pretty cool that you can kind of like do all your single player shenanigans. And once you run out of like energy in single player, you go to multiplayer and you can start grinding and doing some multiplayer stuff. And a lot of that grind will kind of like help you out in single player as well. So it's kind of like being able to play and work and make progress in single player while your single player game save kind of like recharges and like you get back energy and stuff like that. And one of those awesome single player prizes is exactly what we are seeing here, what appears to be called the Nitro Bike, which is actually a little bit of a trike by the looks of it, because in the front you can see two distinct wheels that this bike has. And dude, you got to admit that this thing looks flipping sick. Like, man, there's been a lot of motorcycles dropped throughout these seasons, but this is probably one of my top favorites. Just like, it looks so cool with like the freaking neon glow around it, the two wheels in the front, the freaking like headlight that looks like a little like circle. Like, it kind of has like some Tron vibes to it, but it's just like so unique besides that. And I don't know, man, I'm a sucker for those dual front wheels. I don't know what it is. Two front wheels just get a star going. What can I say? But you got it, man. It does look like a pretty sick bike, and I am definitely excited for it. So let me know what y'all think about this bike in that comment section down below. Where would you rank it upon your favorite bikes? Is this your favorite bike that you have seen in Last Day on Earth thus far? Or are there better bikes that you have seen before that you are a little bit of a bigger fan of? If so, which one would it be? Maybe why? I'd love to hear any and all that type of jazz as we do go ahead and wrap up the information that we do have for today. So yeah, looking forward to what y'all got to say in that comment section down below about the bike, and of course about Season 9 at large as we continue learning more about it. Because again, it's just gonna be so easy. Like, once you hit level 15, you just hit that little button in the bottom right hand corner and boom, you can literally switch over to the crater and start experiencing multiplayer while your single player like person does like recharge and regenerate. And like, you know, it's just like an entirely additional experience, and we're gonna be getting more added to this huge place as well, along with some sort of a big like focus on clans. Like, ideally, hopefully, like, it says available only during clan wars, they continue pushing how important the clans are gonna be. Dude, like, I mean, the existence of the pump jack on the map, how much they're pushing clan wars, I wouldn't be surprised if we finally have the long mythically awaited pump jack location added as a thing, which would be so freaking dope, dude. Because like, that seriously been teasing us ever since like the beginning of Last Day on Earth, like what, 3 years or something like that ago, which is freaking insane, along with just all this multiplayer stuff and action, a completely independent character, and just like, dude, it's definitely exciting to see all this jazz happen. So make sure to let me know in that comment section down below what y'all do think about this rumored Season 9. A lot of things that are coming within it about the bike and all that type of jazz in that comment section down below. And a reminder that that comment is going to put you one third of the way into the weekly $25 iTunes Touch Play Store gift card giveaway. All you got to do as well is make sure to like button, make sure to subscribe. That will show you on today's video. Y'all can go ahead and enter in on every single Last Day on Earth video when Saturday rolls around. We'll pick a random video for the past week, pick a random comment from that random video, and that's will be the winner for the week. And we'll kick off a new weekly giveaway that exact same Saturday as well. So make sure you stay tuned with that notification bell to stay up to date with every single video. Y'all can enter it out for the weekly giveaway, not to mention all the other dope survival games going up on the channel as well. And trust me, if you like Last Day on Earth, you'll be enjoying some of the other stuff going up on the channel. Give it a look when you do see it go live. And oh, I thought it was like zombie footsteps. That was actually just Lexi's footsteps. Okay, I was gonna say it's tweaking me out a little bit. And this appears to be not quite just a base. It appears that this little location that we are raiding appears to be more of a compound, because I saw two distinct structures that we have the capability of breaking into. Nay, make that three! Three different locations we can get into, and they do appear to be all a little bit on the smaller side. So you gotta imagine that they should just be like one wall each and we should be broken into, and there's absolutely nothing in this one except for a freaking woodwork bench for us. And unfortunately, I don't think we can find like ash logs in there, dude. If they added ash logs to base raid loot, you have no idea how hype I would be, dude. That is something that I want to witness. And hello, we have found the chest stuck pile, it appears. Well, 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 we'll be breaking into quite a few of those. And for the sake of curiosity, we gotta see what is on the other side of this wall over here, because it does seem to have better wall protections and, oh, better chests as well. And we could have broken through one of those two walls, so... Well, that's unfortunate. So note to y'all, if y'all come across this base, there are two little walls over there that will save you a lot of hatchet durability if you decide to break into them instead of something else. And obviously, we are about to have a swarm of zombies all up on our grill. Let's go! Love to see the red paint and the electronic circuits. Not too shabby. Hopefully, that is just the surface that we are scratching of the loot that will be available to us. Lexi and Travis are quite the dynamic duo to help us take down some of these zombies with the help, of course, by none other than the pistol, the drizzle, and wow, empty. That hurts to see. But the wrench, the gas, the dat, and that is all great to see. Star, why the red paint? Why not the blue? Because I have a massive red paint shortage, because red paint is so much more widely used than motorcycle designs for some reason. I don't know. Also, I just do have a huge stockpile of freaking blue paint, man. I think it's just easier to come across in general. Let's make sure this is a raid that we got from the Raiders. So you want to make sure if you do bring a chopper along for the ride, always stash things into the baggage of the chopper, because... Well, that is where you, the Raiders, they're gonna ask for a fair share of the loot that you get. However, they don't know about the loot that you get that you put in your chopper, so you can kind of trick them into thinking you had a bad raid and giving them less than they would otherwise ask for. So pretty nifty little trick over there. Definitely capitalize upon it, comrades. Now, let's get to chopping down some of these chests over here. Carrots, and quite a lot of them. Very well, very well. Carrots, I have met my match, it appears. Boop, and there we go. Our hatchet has broke. We're taking that thing down, and oh mama, we got quite a lot of few zombies that we gotta take down as well before we go back to the absolute murder of these chests and breaking into them. And okay, I was gonna say, I thought that there's one more zombie coming our way. Indeed there is. Lexi, thank you for helping me put the finishing blow into her. And oof, I'd take a red ticket, man, but besides that, pretty wackadoodle little chest, not what I was hoping for. Let's see what we got within this one over here. Okay, I mean, also nothing too incredible by any stretch of the imagination. We have this chest over here, and then two more to the little northern section. We got a little bit of wood, which is perfect, because with this stone, I'll be able to craft up another hatchet that I do think that I am going to need. I think I may have underestimated this raid by, like, one hatchet, because, like, yeah, that thing only is one chop left in it, and that's no bueno. Hello, I'm surprised I'm not being swarmed by zombies yet, but what I will be able to do over here is combine some rocks with the wood and create a hatchet. This will be the perfect Yeah, that's the thing though. Note to y'all, the only reason I was comfortable with doing that, right, is because, well, I need another hatchet, and I had plenty of noise to spare before the big one makes his appearance, because at 100 noise, the big one does decide to appear. Nah, luckily for us, we had a little bit of noise to spare and not too much more to break into. And oof, this does appear to be largely on the side of a resource raid, which is, I mean, always a little bit rough to see, bro. Always a little bit rough to see. And this is largely what we have to pick from. So I think that that little chest in that wooden room, I'd say it was probably the best. I mean, there's some cool little doodads and trinkets here and there, but seriously, nothing incredible. At least we did not have to use a C4 to get disappointed by this base, because that is probably the worst. I mean, we could pick up some carrots over here for further cooking and jazz like that. So definitely a few bright spots here and there, but could have been brighter, I tell you what. So, I mean, we've seen what every single chest does have to offer within here. At this point in time, just gonna be a matter of me kind of picking and choosing what in particular I want to bring home out of all of these options, but definitely nothing like super standout, especially, like, don't get me wrong, like bell bearings and wires are pretty nifty and whatnot, but I just have huge stockpiles of these back at home already. So, like, to the point where I don't really know if I need more. Obviously, I'll continue looting because I'm a lootaholic, bro. And even if I don't need more, I will probably still try to find a way to shove it somewhere into my base storage. That is how the Wild Star works. But, might not be the best idea overall, but I will continue doing it, comrades. But yeah, looking forward to what y'all got to say in that comment section down below. Best of luck in the giveaway, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and stay tuned, because also whenever season 9 does drop, plenty of videos coming out about it, especially with the multiplayer context. We might get to team up with a few other YouTubers and have a little bit of fun with them as well. So, Yeah, banger videos coming your way. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. And of course, today we also announced the winner of this past week's $25 iTunes Play Store gift card giveaway. So make sure you check that pinned comment in that comment section down below where the winner will be posted. The randomly chosen comment from the randomly chosen video from this past week. If that is you, make sure to reply to that pinned comment and let me know the best way that I can privately get in contact with you so we can go ahead and hook you up with that code that you have won, my good sir and oh my dom, because I can't just reply to the winning comment and be like, hey, here's your code, because, well, everyone can see a reply to a comment, and a code isn't exactly something that you want everyone to see, you know? So go ahead and let me know in reply to that pinned comment the best way that I can get in touch with you. Otherwise, best of luck, everyone else, in the brand new $25 iTunes Play Store gift card giveaway. Kick it off today, where the new winner will be announced on a Saturday's Last Day on Earth video, and then the process will repeat as a new giveaway does begin, and so on and so forth. But with that said, with that done, that's going to go to start bringing an end to this episode. The Last Day on Earth Survival. Thank you guys a whole ton for watching. Have yourselves an awesome one, and I'll talk to you in the next one. See ya.